Hi friends, this is Soniya here and today I thought why not to talk about the most used thing in any of the mixed media or your decoupage product, that is chalk paint and acrylic paint. So many a times I have been asked that what is the difference between chalk paint and acrylic paint? Can we use chalk paint instead of acrylic paint or vice versa? So I thought why not to make a video with the basic information, whatever I know, I can share it with you all out there and let you know that how I use them or how I prefer using them. So let's get started. Like you can see here, I have a bunch of shades in chalk paint and acrylic paint. So first we'll start with the acrylic paint. So these acrylic colors, they come in different size jars. They come in small glass jar bottles also, this also, then you even get acrylic color tubes also, and then this is approximately 100 ml plastic jar. You even get the bigger jars, the bigger containers of these acrylic colors. Now on the other hand, chalk paint, this one is from Craftyscrappers. This particular piece is, yeah, this is 100 ml. In the chalk paints, usually you get this size bottle or a little more bigger size bottle, but not more than that, because I have not seen the very big jars of chalk paint as what you get for acrylic paints. And in chalk paints, you get many other varieties of shades and the finish. This can be used in glass, paper, metal, wood and many other materials. So that is something which you can really explore about the chalk paints. Next, do you need to prep up the base before using your paints, the chalk paints and the acrylic paints? Like I said, it always depends on what kind of artwork you are doing. If you are working on any of your mixed media projects where you are going to have different layers, then you need to have your gesso for your as a primer for your base. And if you are doing just a card or a decoupage project or anything, then you can apply this directly on your base. Thought why not to do some experiment with the paper. So here I have this brown color, thick, very very thick cardboard paper. It's not actually cardboard, it's a 250-300 GSM paper, which is really thick, as good as the cardboard piece only. So here I'm going to have my two brushes and I'm going to show you that how it looks when you apply the color. So I'm going to pick one shade of it. So maybe I'll take the red color, and with this I'm going to take this Lyrical Birdie. It's a blue color shade. So with the chalk paint, so there are two ways in which you can apply your chalk paint, that is paintbrush, and the other option is with your sponge daubers. So for this video I'll be using my paintbrushes only. So you can see when you apply the color, the chalk paint, it is shiny. And now on the other hand, we'll be using our acrylic color. And so when it comes to the application, acrylic colors are really 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 smooth, because it is a very thinner if you compare it with the chalk paint. So chalk paints are thicker, acrylic paints are really thin, so spreading this is a little easy task. And now if you can see, this border is drying out in chalk paint and this acrylic color. So you can see that the color changes when it dries out. I'll use my heat gun to speed up the drying process so that you guys can see the difference. Now you can see both the portions are shining, right? So now you can see, if I put it on my light, this is a glossy one. Now this is complete matte. So chalk paints are complete matte thing. Okay, so can you see the color? Yeah. And if I put it on light, only this color is shining, not this one. So my acrylic color and chalk paint, maybe I can write it here with my pen so you can see the difference. This is glossy, this is matte. Although in the jar, I could not find anywhere written that it is glossy, but when I use it on paper, you can see this one is a gloss. This one has glossy effect. This is completely matte. I have this plywood piece here with me, and I thought why not to use my colors on this, because this is a medium on which most of the time I work. I use MDF blocks, I use plywood pieces, I use many other blocks. So this works perfectly. Now again, I'm going to apply my color on this. See, if I would have been doing any other color or thing on this, then I would have used gesso, but I'm going to use the raw colors on my base without any prep or the primer thing, and I'll show you. Now again, I'm going to use my chalk paint. And so when I say that acrylic paints are really smooth, that does not mean that my chalk paints are not smooth. They are equally smooth, but yes, if you compare it with acrylic colors, the acrylic paints are a little more smoother. Now here I'm going to apply my acrylic colors, and again I'm going to use my heat gun to speed up the drying. So let me just show you. So again, when it's wet, both the parts are shiny, and now I'm going to use my heat gun here. So you can see it is coming to its actual color when it dries out, and the acrylic colors remain same. So if you are a person who wants some exact shade, then maybe you need to work out a little with chalk paint, and acrylic colors are going to be as it is. So now again, you can see if I put light on this, this is not the matte finish. If I don't have any light or any direct lighting to my object, this is completely matte. But if you take it to some brighter areas, this is going to shine. This is completely matte. This is completely, completely matte. Now I'm going to do this on the reverse side with my prepped up base, and for that I'm going to use my gesso. Now here I'm going to use my Finnabare gesso. It's an artistic white gesso box, and I'm going to just apply a coat of gesso on my block, and I'm going to apply a very thin layer because I just want you guys to have a look and feel of how the color looks once you prep up the base, and you can actually see the difference. So like I always say, that the material what you are using depends on the kind of use of it, kind of look and feel you want with that. So the only best option what I can think of is buy these materials, try them out, and you will know that how this should be used or how this can be used. Now I'll keep this jar aside. I'll use my heat gun to dry this out. Now my gesso has dried out completely. And now again, I'll start with my chalk paint. On one side, I'm going to apply my chalk paint, and you can see how amazing, amazing it looks. Can you see this? Again, it's shiny, but it is going to be complete matte, and that's the best thing about Craftyscrappers chalk paint, because if they say matte finish, it is going to be completely matte. Now I'm going to use my acrylic color on the other side, and now again I'm going to use my heat gun. So let me first show you that again these two are shiny. You can see the color difference here. It is changing to matte, and again this is the same glossy one. And now can you see the difference? Yeah, so now if you compare it with this, can you see the color difference? This one is darker, this one is light. It can be because of the base color of the cardstock, but the chalk paint shades are, it's exactly same. So that's the best part of using your chalk paints, because chalk paint, you apply it on any surface, it is not going to change its color. But whereas on the with the acrylic colors, it depends on the shade you are using, it depends on the base what you are using, the colors are going to change. So please make sure that you need to keep these basic things in mind, that one, which surface you are using, secondly, what's the purpose of that area, the surface where you are going to apply this, and third, how you're prepping up your base, because it is actually going to make a difference. Now if you see, this base is white, this base is brown, so the red color is different, but the blue color is exact same. Secondly, I have not prepped up the base. Here I have prepped up the base with the gesso. So yes, you can definitely see the color difference. Whereas if I turn this side, again you can see, here I had not used any gesso. This was just my raw blank. And here you can see the difference in red color. This is darker, this is light. So the acrylic colors, they react with the base color. It takes a little time, or you can say it does not gel with the base color very nicely. So you need to make sure that you choose your colors accordingly. So I hope this small tutorial was helpful for you guys, and thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.